Hello friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I will be sharing my summer harvest from small and beautiful balcony garden. Also, I will be sharing one recipe at the end from my garden to plate. It's a very easy and tasty vegetarian recipe in which no cream, no sugar, no butter, no cashew, yet very silky smooth and creamy capsicum do piazza recipe. If you like my videos, do like, share and subscribe to my channel, Live Tasty, Be Happy. This is my beautiful little garden in the balcony. You would have seen in all my garden videos. If you are new to my channel, then this is for all of you to just give a little update. All the plants in my balcony are all vegetable. Mostly they are edible vegetables. Mostly tomatoes, peppers and green leafy vegetables. You can see I have Malabar spinach, cherry tomatoes, normal different kind of tomatoes and lot of peppers also. Only one fruit available here is strawberry plant. This is the strawberry plant in which there is a white flower. These all are bell peppers and banana peppers. In this garden video, you will be seeing all the harvest which I have been doing all through the week. Every week I will be having something or the other for me from this little garden. Most of them are tomatoes and peppers. They are nice, good in harvest. They give lot of produce too. This plant is a beetle leaf plant. It's a very nice growing plant. You can see how betel leaves are big in size. Though I don't eat betel leaves, still I have a plant. I love it. This is my curry leaf plant. Last video, if you had seen, there will be lot of small plants in the bottom. I propagated 4 to 5 pots extra. That's all. This is the small garden in my house. See how beautiful yellow roses, bunch of 10 to 12 flowers. Just I added Epsom salt 1 tablespoon every month. You will get nice beautiful flowers if you have rose plant. Now I am doing all my harvest for a day. All these are banana peppers and cherry tomatoes. This cherry tomato plant is worth having it in a balcony because it gives lot of harvest. Every day you will have handful of cherry tomatoes. Once the plant grows, you will have keep on having tomatoes. You can see these chilies also, how nice long big green chilies. They are not very spicy but nice ones, nice flavorful chili. This Malabar spinach is also growing well. In my next video I will show. It is much more bushy and very big now. Now you can see these celebrity tomatoes are also having lot of tomatoes. Almost in this plant itself I have 10 to 15 tomatoes now, which will be keep on ripening now and then. Now you can see one tomato has ripened and same way cherry tomatoes too. Today we are going to see strawberries also has grown nice big. They will be growing very fast. In no time, in 1 or 2 days, those strawberries become big. I have lot of peppers, that is bell pepper and banana pepper. This banana pepper is also very worth having it in a garden. Each and every plant will have 4 to 5 banana peppers every time. See this tomato, how nice and beautiful. With my gardening experience, I recommend you to always have a cherry tomato plant, normal tomatoes, banana peppers, chili plants, curry leaf plant. All these give really very good harvest. Always, even bell pepper, green bell pepper. Last year I was having much more bigger size of bell pepper. I don't know why this year it is not growing very big, but still I have good harvest. This purple bell pepper is new for me. This year only I tried that plant. This also is keep on giving me 1 or 2 bell peppers every time. But this banana peppers still after harvesting also I have lot of small banana peppers which will be for my next week. Every week I am getting 10 at least 10 of banana peppers. Today I will be sharing a recipe with these capsicums. And after this video, next video will be a special recipe with these banana peppers, which is also for Eid special. It's so happy and satisfying to have a nice homegrown organic vegetables from your garden itself. Small or big, homegrown fresh vegetables give you more satisfaction. Now let's move on to green leafy vegetables. This is Ponnangani Keerai or Ponnugannu. In Andhra they call it Ponnugannu. These are also growing very very fast. They grow like fire, just like how you will tell mint leaves, if you have little they will be growing like fire. The same way these green leafy Ponnangani also grows very fast. I have these green leafy, that is 4 pots of this spinach I have, because it is very very good for eyesight. I want my kids to have them every week. I try to give them most of the time. For that reason I grow this a lot. Almost 4 pots I have. Every pot if I harvest, it will give so much that I can use it for 2 days. See how much I was able to harvest out of one pot. It will be just enough for 2 days. I prepared this spinach mixed with dal, which is very very tasty and very healthy too. I will be sharing that recipe also very soon. Now let's move on to our capsicum do piyaza recipe, which is very very easy. Today I will be using this capsicum and tomato, but the banana peppers I will be posting the recipe next. First I have taken enough oil. In that I am going to fry only the capsicum and onions. All are nice big pieces, do not cut them into fine pieces. In that same oil I have just added 1 teaspoon of zeera and 1 big onion I have taken and finely chopped. Roast it nicely, fry it nicely until it is little bit brown, not too brown. Now I am adding ginger garlic paste. Nicely fry it, followed by I will be adding 2 tablespoons of besan or gram flour. This is the secret ingredient in this recipe. This will give nice creaminess and nice texture to the gravy. For that I will be roasting it nicely. When you are using this gram flour, you should add little extra oil because it needs to be roasted in the oil itself. Followed by I am adding tomato, 1 large tomato, nice finely chopped. Now I am adding 1 teaspoon of chili powder and 1 teaspoon of zeera powder. I am not adding too many ingredients. Always keep the water ready by the side when you are using gram flour. Easily the masala will become thick very soon. For that reason only we should keep water and keep adding according to the consistency we require. Nicely give it a good mix, add enough water and cover it and cook for 5 minutes. Now I also added the salt. Check the salt according to the salt level you like. Nicely give it a good mix. Mix water also if you want and keep it on medium flame until it comes to a boil. Now you can add the fried onions and capsicum in this itself. Then give it a good mix. Nicely give it a good mix. Then I will be adding kasuri methi and coriander leaves. Very few ingredients, but believe me friends, this dish is very very creamy, very very tasty and delicious. Nowhere you will miss the butter or the cream or even cashew or almond paste. We give it a good mix and cover the lid and off the flames. In that heat itself, the capsicum and onions will become nice, soft and tender. Our creamy and smooth and silky capsicum do piyaza is ready. You can also add paneer in this same dish if you want. Hope you all like it. If you like my videos, do like, share and subscribe to my channel. Live tasty, be happy. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.